Welcome back. The Himalayan state of Uttaranchal is targeting to produce 20,000 megawatt hydropower in the next few years. The young state of Uttaranchal has been quick to tap hydropower, having initiated projects to capture half the assessed potential. This could help in reducing the power supply gap in the country.
12 February 2001 was a new dawn in the power sector of Uttarakhand when UJVNL came into existence. It aims to help the state become a power major and be called an Urja Pradesh. UJVNL is a wholly owned corporation of the government of Uttarakhand, set up for managing hydropower generation at existing power stations. It's also involved in development promotions of new hydro projects.
See, at present, the installed capacity of Uttaranchal Jal Vidyut Nigam is 1304 megawatt, and in future, we are going to add Palamneri 480 megawatt, Bhairoghati 381 megawatt, Bhawalanand Prayag 300 megawatt, and again we are also going to start Lakhwar Vyasi project of 420 megawatt, Kishav Dam project of 600 megawatt. And I am also going to increase the income of Uttarakhand Jal Vidyut Nigam. We will be able to arrange more than 1000 crore internal resources within 2 years' time, and then we will have a lot of investment available from the bank also. So there is no problem of fund. Earlier we could not develop much, but now we are organized and we are going to have a lot of technical officers, and with the support of government, we are going to make Uttarakhand Jal Vidyut Nigam immediately. We are going to install low many power projects which are coming, and we have a plan to make it Uttarakhand state as a capital of Urja.
UJVNL operates hydropower plants with generation capacity of 0.2 megawatt to 240 megawatt. The total production per year is about 1000 megawatt. UJVNL has 34 projects under operation with an aggregated capacity of more than 1400 megawatt. More than 14 projects are under different stages of implementation. It's primarily responsible for the small hydro development in Uttarakhand and is the nodal agency to speed up this development.
Uttarakhand government has provided a lot of support to the private people. See, land acquisition is better here, they can be done faster speed. Secondly, law and order is very good. Tax concession in the industries are also here. So all these things government of Uttarakhand is providing, and while allotting the project also, government of Uttarakhand wants that in single window all clearances will be provided to the developers, which will help in the private operators to develop hydro projects, especially in Uttarakhand.
Environmental and social challenges are amongst the major issues faced by the hydropower developers. Most hydropower sites are located in relatively fragile Himalayan ecosystem and require thorough environmental impact assessment. The lack of trained manpower to execute and operate plants in remote and risky terrain is another constraint faced by the developers. Inadequate detailed project reports, lack of understanding of the hydrogeology of the site, silting and remote locations with poor logistics are other major challenges faced by the developers.
Once single window clearances are provided, in that case only hydro projects can come quickly. Otherwise, if you are going to run post to pillar for getting clearances, naturally clearances are taking a lot of time. But now government has realized that without development of hydropower projects in India, the energy security is not possible. We can't import coal and then generate power at cheaper rate. Secondly, global warming is also causing great concern to us. With the help of hydropower, global warming problems will also be solved. Drinking water problems will be solved, irrigation water problems will be solved.
In a short period of 4 years since its formation, UJVNL has carved out a place in the power sector as a progressive and efficient operator. Though the state is more or less sufficient in its energy generation to meet its own requirements, it is committed to develop its huge hydropower resources in an early and efficient manner for economic well-being and growth of the state and its people. Let's move on. Increase in use of energy in different sectors of the economy is an area of concern for India. Power quality and reliability have been amongst the biggest problems faced by industries for the last 3 decades. A systematic approach to monitor industrial energy consumption and to pinpoint sources of wastage is known as energy audit. In the present energy scenario and the era of industrial competition, energy auditing has become a very important part of any industrial activity.
The energy audit serves to identify all the energy streams in a facility, qualify energy uses with its discrete functions in an attempt to balance the total energy input with its use. Energy audit is thus the key to a systematic approach for decision making in the area of energy management. As a result, the energy audit study becomes an effective tool in defining and pursuing comprehensive energy management program. An energy audit study helps an organization to understand and analyze its energy utilization and identify areas where energy can be reduced, decide on how to budget energy use, plan and practice feasible energy conservation methods that will enhance the energy efficiency, curtail energy wastage, and substantially reduce energy costs.
Last year, we did an energy audit. And we realized to our horror that our air conditioners, you know, are guzzling energy. And basis what we saw through that audit, we took a decision to change all the air conditioners of this office. And we were assured that, you know, the payback of this investment, which we made, which was substantial, would be around 20 months. Now imagine how much, you know, money was leaking out. So we changed the air conditioners, and now we are monitoring this, and we find that we are saving a very substantial amount of money in terms of energy which is conserved because of new, good quality, high rated air conditioner.
In most households, the refrigerator is the single biggest energy consuming kitchen appliance. Replacing a refrigerator bought in past with a new star rated qualified model would save enough energy to light the average household for nearly 4 months. Star rated qualified refrigerator models use high efficiency compressors, improved insulation and more precise temperature and defrost mechanisms to improve energy efficiencies. Here are some simple tips for your refrigerator. Do not open the door of your refrigerator frequently and make sure that the doors are airtight. Set the thermostat in medium cooling position. Do not overload your refrigerator. Defrost at regular intervals as frost buildup increases the amount of energy needed to keep the motor running. Leave enough space between your refrigerators and the walls so that air can easily circulate around the refrigerator. Cover liquids and wrap the food stored in the refrigerator as open food items release moisture and force the compressor to work harder. Avoid putting hot or warm food straight into the fridge as this puts extra pressure on the cooling system and uses more power. With this, we come to an end of today's episode. Do send us your suggestions and views at powernews@utvnet.com. Otherwise, call us on 011-405-60701. Do join us next week for more news updates. Have a great week ahead.